I've heard people say that they would go mad without their partner, that their partner keeps them healthy, their partner keeps them mentally stable. And these are all wonderful things if you have a supportive partner, but actually, it can be quite detrimental too. Let me explain. It's great if they help us with our health and happiness, but the truth is, that's our responsibility first. It's easy to depend on someone else for our own needs. We don't have to take responsibility. We don't have to grow, we don't have to focus. It's like outsourcing our own well-being. The challenging thing is, we can't guarantee that they're always going to be there. Which means, if they move further away, we move further away from our own well-being. We have to learn to carry ourselves. If we over-depend on others, they'll drop us quicker than they picked us up. This isn't a negative message. It's a message for long-term growth. It's important that our health and happiness starts with us first. Not your partner, not your job, not your friends, not your family. Happiness is how we feel about ourselves when we're by ourselves. Often we feel amazing when we're surrounded by people, but when we're alone, we feel lonely and disconnected. When there's space and silence, we feel unhappy and depressed. It's in those moments where we realize how we feel about ourselves is so much more important. It's been famously said, don't depend on anyone too much in this world because even your own shadow leaves you in the darkness. There are people that are always there for you in the dark times and the good times. Recognize them, acknowledge them, and express gratitude, but don't depend on them wholeheartedly. And the way to know whether you're over-dependent is when your dependence drains the other person's time and energy. It ends up pushing them away rather than bringing them closer. There are two big mistakes we make. We either go to everyone with each of our problems, or we go to one person with all of our problems. Neither of those works. In the first scenario, we feel overwhelmed by all of the opinions and views on what we should do. In the second one, we put so much pressure and burden onto the other person that they can no longer carry the weight. Instead, we have to form a group of people, different experts, different people, different leaders and guides for different areas of our lives. The three areas in which we need mentors, coaches, and guides are care, competence, and character. There are some people in our life that will always give us care. Their main focus will always be our mental and physical health. The second type of mentor or coach that we need in our life is competence. Someone who has a skill set in the area that we want to grow in. Someone who's living their passion. Someone who's actually an expert in an area where we want to develop. And finally, we have those in our life of deep character. People who can guide us in the toughest of times. People who can be honest with us when no one else can. And people who can share their truth with us when we're at our biggest and most challenging moments. But everyone has at least one. And don't forget this, no one is coming to save you. You have to save yourself. No one is coming to change your life. You have to change yourself. Because remember, you have to be your own hero and save your own heart. Because sometimes the people you can't live without can live without you.